Donald Trump came out saying that he was assassinated, the ambassador, by a radical Islamic terrorist. You know, and then he went on to talk about ISIS. Obviously, the government in Turkey is saying it's a part of a political group led by a cleric here in the United States. There are al-Qaeda documents found in this man's home. Do you feel at this point there's any way to know whether he's trying to defend civilians in Aleppo or part of ISIS or what?
Well, very hard to say whether he's part of ISIS. As you know, in Syria, there are basically two wars going on. There's one that's against ISIS, and then there's a war of a kind of mass uprising against the government, against the Alawite or Shia leading government. And much of this mass uprising is comprised of Sunnis, some of whom are quite radical, the al-Nusra Front and a few others. He sounds like he's talking about that situation rather than the situation going on more in the desert and also in Iraq. So he doesn't seem more so much an ISIS member as he seems someone from this internal Syria mess. And of course, Turks have had a really tough time. They started with supporting Assad, then they changed, and now recently they've kind of gone back to their original position. They seem to be working with the Russians.
Right, and now, of course, they're blaming a man in the United States for this attack, this assassination, a political exile they want deported. John Kerry told them this was absurd today. His spokesman, frankly, was not diplomatic about this. He was very, very clear. Here's John Kirby.
Any notion that the United States was in any way supportive of this or behind this or even indirectly involved is absolutely ridiculous.
Absolutely ridiculous. Could this escalate, Ambassador?
Absolutely ridiculous is not usually a diplomatic term of art. So I think this can escalate. And I think what is clear is that something is happening in Turkey, especially with this Erdogan regime, especially after the coup attempt. And they are becoming much closer to Russia and much more willing, I think, to have Russia take the diplomatic lead. So I think this assassination really speaks to some really strong undercurrents that are going on now, and we'll have to see how this plays out. I mean, it's quite extraordinary that Russia has a diplomatic lead and the U.S. has been reduced to sort of getting angry at the U.N. Security Council and otherwise not really playing a direct role in the diplomacy.